I am Eva Cernadas from the CITIUS, Research Center of Intelligent Technology from the University of Santiago de Compostela, Spain. And I am going to present the work entitled Embedded Ethics to Teach Machine Learning Courses and Experience. Artificial intelligence is increasingly influencing the opinions and behavior of people in everyday life. Skills in artificial intelligence are demanded by companies and organizations to offer new services and increase their profits. It can improve the well-being of people, but it also presents many problems that can be harmful for the citizen, especially women. In fact, some publications have highlighted the lack of neutrality of machine learning algorithms and their implicit gender biases. Although women represent 50% of the world's population that consume technology, less than 25% are researchers. The latest report of UNESCO recommends to develop gender equality and ethical principles in the artificial intelligence curriculum. Understanding the strengths and limitations of artificial intelligence is critical to avoid reproducing or even amplifying structural inequalities. Although both the European Union and Spain has a regulatory framework to introduce the gender perspective in higher education, the inclusion of gender perspective is still very low in Spanish universities, even SCEA in computer engineering and artificial intelligence degrees. More materials and experience are needed to help and inspire university teachers. Gender skills are key in the field of engineering degrees, with only 25% of female students and only 13% in computer science degrees. The overrepresentation of men in the design of these technologies could limit the advances in gender equality for the future. Gender balance in machine learning is therefore crucial to prevent algorithms from perpetuating gender ideologies that disadvantage women. We incorporated the gender perspective in two courses of machine learning: Fundamentals of Machine Learning for Computer Vision, which is a course of International Master in Computer Vision. We have 14 students enrolled, 11 men and 3 women. The course is online teaching. The methodology used was discussing in a forum each week an ethical and gender aspect. In the machine learning course, which is an optional course degree in computer engineering, we had 5 students enrolled, 1 woman and 4 men. The methodology used was face-to-face discussions in the lab classrooms, use of inclusive language in Galician language, and visibilization of women in artificial intelligence. For this course, here are the first entries made in the forum. The debate begins with the website of Gender Innovation, which is a project promoted by Dr. Londa Schiebinger. It was surprised by the critical capacity of the students with the cases of inequality presented on this page. For example, relating to the difference in the severity of traffic accidents for men and women. Other problems identified were face recognition algorithms, speech recognition system, search engines, and machine translators. Regarding machine translator, I suggested students to translate a test from Spanish into English and then translate the test back into Spanish. The experiment was done by a student and shared in the forum, concluding that translators from English to Spanish always translate into masculine professions that are socially associated with the masculine gender, even though in the original test they were feminine. In this course, we increment the qualification of students who participate in the forum, and 47% of the students participated, all of the women and 27% of men. The female gender showed a greater sensitivity to ethical issues than the men, being more critical with the discrimination issues of artificial intelligence. In the machine learning course, all the students participate because the debate was made in the lab sessions. Some comments of the students along the courses were: to eliminate biases from our algorithms, we need to eliminate them from ourselves. Gender biases should be the main concern when developing artificial intelligence systems. Data collected from networks and used in machine learning algorithms must be monitored by a diverse group of people to avoid to reproduce gender biases. And another question was, should the legislation forbid, for ethical and moral reasons, the use of facial recognition for surveillance? And the conclusion of this first year was, the participation and sensitivity related to gender and ethics issues in artificial intelligence of female students is higher than male students. We were surprised by the ethical level of a part of the students, mostly female. They highlighted the diversity to be taken into account when designing machine learning algorithms in the future. And about 50% of students participate and show a high sensitivity with the danger of artificial intelligence. Thank you for your attention.